For a bath. Would you find him for me, Pinky?
Okay, Mom. He's not in here. There you are, Tyler. It's time for your bath.
Uh-uh. I don't wanna.
You love taking baths.
I just got this really cool pirate tattoo, and I don't wanna wash it off.
Don't want a bath? That gives me an idea.
Pinky? Are you gonna make up a story?
Yes, sir, Rudy Positoony.
Yes, sir, Rudy Positoony. We're going to the story box, where Pinky's really good at making up stories, and every story rocks. Story box.
Okay, so one day in Smack Dab Park, Tyler was having a whole lot of fun playing leapfrog with his friend Lulu. Whenever Tyler tumbled onto the grass, he got grass stains all over his hands and knees. Then, Tyler and Lulu made mud pies.
Hi, Daphne. Want a mud pie?
Ew! That is so... ew! You need a bath really bad. You look... hideous.
Wait a minute, Pinky.
Really, really gross. I don't like where the story's going.
Into the bathtub.
Oh, no. This story's about someone who never takes a bath. He gets as dirty as he wants to every day.
Really? What happens next?
Let's see. After an exciting day of leapfrogging, dirt jumping, and mud pie making, Tyler said goodbye to Lulu and headed home. Way, a walnut fell into his dirty hair.
Ow!
Tyler's hair was so dirty that a walnut tree started to grow right there on top of his head. People stared at him because he looked so funny.
What are you staring at?
Then Tyler finally got home.
Whoa, Tyler! Your hair is getting bushy. That's because I've been playing. I'll just comb it.
Tyler, I think you're going to need a really big comb and maybe a bath.
Nuh-uh. Hey, it's kind of neat having a tree for hair.
Woo! Those walnuts look really tasty. I can use them for baking.
When Tyler woke up the next day, something else weird was happening to him.
Tyler! Breakfast is ready!
What? I can't hear you!
His ears are so full of dirt, potatoes were growing out of them.
Hey, everybody! I'm growing potatoes out of my ears!
That's old news, Tyler.
We read all about it here in the Weekly Wacky Weird News! It says the legend of Twigfoot is real and in Great Big City! Run for it!
Is that me? Maybe this isn't so neat anymore. I'm starting to look sorta... hideous.
Well, that's what happens when you get too dirty. but you sure are handy. Your father loves baked potatoes.
Tyler's walnut hair was getting so big, it was time for a trim. So off they went to Madame Curl's house of hair.
This is a house of hair, not a house of walnut trees. And you are the legend of Twigfoot.
Don't be scared. He's not Twigfoot. He's just a little boy who needs a haircut and a bath.
No bath.
I must do this work. I took the hairstylist's oath, so I can never turn away a customer.
But Madame Curl didn't know what to use to cut Tyler's crazy hair. Should she use a flippity-floppity fish? Nah, too flippity. So, how about a big plumber's plunger? Nope, too sploochy. So how about a nice hedge trimmer for a buzz cut? Perfect!
Oh, this is some crazy tree you've got on this head.
Kids, they grow like weeds, don't they?
They do as they are. The legendary Twigfoot. I'm sorry. The faster I cut, the faster it grows.
That's okay, Madame Curl. Thanks for trying.
Must be street cleaning day. Hi, Pee.
Hi, Pinky. It's Twigfoot! Run for it!
Oh, it's him!
Everywhere he went, people thought Tyler was Twigfoot. Even at the shoe store.
It's Twigfoot!
Tyler really needed new shoes. Mushrooms were growing from his dirty toes.
Take these and go!
The only shoes that fit Tyler were special dark and roomy shoes, so the mushrooms had room to grow.
These shoes are really clunky. Hi, Lulu. Wanna play?
It's me, Tyler. You can't fool me. You're Twigfoot and you're... hideous!
Even my friend won't play with me.
I am not Twigfoot. I am a little kid. And I'm sick of being... hideous! I'm gonna go home and take a bath right now. Oh, no! I can't fit through the door anymore. What am I gonna do?
Looks like it's time for me to think big.
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think!
Then it happened. Pinky had a big idea. Pinky Dinky Doo knew just what to do. It's street cleaning day. We'll get the street sweeper to give you a good cleaning. Hey, Pee! Over here! I need a good cleaning!
Hey, aren't you that Twigfoot kid?
Not for long! Let me have it! In no time at all. Tyler was the cleanest kid ever. Hey! I'm not... hideous anymore. Hey, Tyler, wanna play?
Sure! What happened? Pretty much. The end.
Okay, I get it. I'm ready for my bath. But I sure wish I could keep my tattoo.
Here, just keep this dishwashing glove around it so it doesn't get wet.
It's pretty great to have a sister as smart as you, Pinky.
Thanks.
Sounds like game time. Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Play the Great Big Fancy Word Game. It's the Great Big Fancy Word Game.
That's my favorite!
In my made-up story, the Great Big Fancy Word was...
hideous! It means really, really gross.
That's right, little brother! Okay, here's how we play. When you see a picture of Tyler and he looks really, really gross, shout out the word hideous. Let's try it once. Ready? Hideous! But when you see a picture of Tyler and he doesn't look really, really gross, do this. Let's play. Great big fancy words. Let's play What's the Name of My Story?
What's the name of my story?
Here are three story names. Tyler and the Astronaut. Tyler and the Legend of Twigfoot. Tyler and the Dancing Bananas. So, what do you think is a good name for my story? Remember, it's gotta be about what happened in my made-up story. If it is, you say yes.
And if it isn't about something that happened in your made-up story, we shout, no!
That's right. Let's play. Is the name of my made-up story Tyler and the Astronaut? No! The story wasn't about an astronaut. Right. How about Tyler and the Dancing Bananas? No! Okay, how about Tyler and the Legend of Twigfoot?
Yes! That's a great name for your story!
That's right, little brother.
Yeah!
I love making up stories. I'll bet you can make up a story, too. Rainy day. Wow, look at that rain. So much for a picnic in the park.
That ruins everything.
Rain ruins everything. That gives me an idea.
Pinky, are you gonna make up a story?
Yes, sir, Rooney Positoony.
So one day in Great Big City, it was raining. At first, it was just a sprinkle, then a drizzle, then it started to rain harder and harder, and then...
Flash, we have a radio weather alert. It is now raining cats and dogs.
Huh? That doesn't really happen.
Oh, yes, it does. Just look out the window.
Hey! It really is raining cats and dogs.
Wait a minute, Pinky.
You were right. It doesn't really rain cats and dogs. That's just a saying. Well, yeah, but since this is a made-up story, anything can happen. What happens next? Let's see. Pinky had never seen anything like this before. Tyler, Mr. Guinea Pig, come here, quick!
It's raining cats and dogs.
Pretty amazing, huh?
Look, the doctor chasing the cat.
Hey, that's not very nice.
And listen to that noise.
Yeah, it's a real cacophony.
I know what
cacophony means.
It's a bunch of loud noises that sound really, really bad.
Pinky, Tyler, and Mr. Guinea Pig ran outside to quiet things down and help the cats.
Dear kitty kitty!
This way! Quick, close the door!
Now what?
We bring them upstairs. Then Pinky, Tyler, and Mr. Guinea Pig took the kitties into the elevator. They had everything under
control. They thought. Nice, kitty.
Don't play with the elevator buttons.
Don't climb up the wall.
Or the ceiling. Everybody out.
Back in the apartment. Pinky started to wonder if this was such a good idea after all. Oh. Careful, kitties!
We have to do something!
And fast! Okay now, kitties. You need to stop all this running around and settle down.
Hey, Pinky, I think they like the singing.
You may be onto something, Tyler. Maybe we can sing to get their attention. Come on, let's get all the cats together.
Okay, kitties, listen to this. The rain's coming down, now it's wet all over town. You splash me and I'll splash you and we'll get water in our shoe.
Oh, Pinky, you know how cats make me sneeze. Achoo!
Sorry, Mom, I forgot.
Now what do we do?
Okay, kitties, we are gonna go singing in the rain. Hey, it stopped raining.
Can they sing anyway?
Sure.
What do you know? Singing cats.
Oh, no! This is a horrible cacophony. Cats, dogs, you need to sing together.
What a racket!
Can't you keep those animals quiet?
They're disturbing the peace.
Sing by themselves.
Oh no, this is hurting my ears. Looks like it's time for me to think big.
What did you say, Pinky? I can't hear you.
Looks like it's time for me to think big.
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think.
Pinky Doo knew just what to do. I know! We'll sing the song so the cats and dogs each have their own turn. But it will sound nice this time. Huh? I'll show you.
The rain's coming down, now it's wet all over town. You splash me and I'll splash you and we'll get water in our shoe.
Okay, dogs, you sing first.
Cacophony.
exactly what happened. Pretty much. The end.
Great story, Pinky.
Thanks.
You know, Pinky, the rain isn't ruining our day at all. It's gonna be great.
Glad to hear it, little brother.
Sounds like game time.
Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Okay, let's play a game called What Came First?
What came first?
I'm going to show you something that happened in my story.
And we're gonna say what came first. Yeah!
That's right, little brother. Hope you're ready to play. Okay, what happened first? Was it I had my big idea? Or was it the cats and dogs were making a lot of noise? So, what came first? My big idea? Or a lot of noise?
Cats and dogs making a lot of noise. That happened before you had your big idea.
You're right. Okay, so what came next in my story? Was it the cats and dogs took turns singing? Or I had my big idea? So, what came next in my story? They took turns singing or big idea?
Big idea!
Right! First, the cats and dogs made a lot of noise. Then, I had my big idea. And then, the cats and dogs took turns singing. And that's exactly how it happened. Let's play What Is That Sound?
What is that sound?
You're gonna hear three different sounds, and only one is from my made-up story.
And that will be the sound of the cats and dogs making a lot of noise.
That's right, little brother. Let's play. So what do you think? Is that the sound of cats and dogs making a lot of noise?
No. That's a rooster.
What do you think? Is that the sound of cats and dogs making a lot of noise?
No.
Or is that the sound of cats and dogs making a lot of noise?
Yeah!
That's it! That is the sound of cats and dogs making a lot of noise.
Yeah!
I love making up stories. I'll bet you can make up a story too.